Welcome to online class. My dear students, how are you? I hope all are fit and fine. I also hope that in this pandemic situation, you will stay at home and study. I am M.D. Mahmoodur Rahman, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Milestone College. Today, I am going to discuss some important topics from second chapter of first part, name qualitative chemistry. Topics are use of UV radiation to detect fake currency note or passport, use of IRS in medical treatment, MRI test in diagnosis of disease, flame test, identification of basic radicals and acid radicals in solution. At first, use of UV radiation to detect fake currency notes or passport. The wavelengths of UV rays lie in between 10 nanometer to 380 nanometers. In original currency notes or passport, the fluorescent substance used as a security point. This is not seen in naked eye. When the original notes or passport kept under the UV ray, then fluorescent substance absorb energy from the UV ray, whose wavelengths lie in between 200 nanometer to 380 nanometer, and radiate the visible lights, whose wavelengths 380 nanometer to 700 nanometer. That means this fluorescent substance absorb the energy of short wavelengths and radiate the energy of long wavelengths. Then the characteristic color is shown, but in fake currency note or passport, it is not possible to use the fluorescent substance as a security point. That's why they will not show any color under UV ray. Now, use of IRS in medical treatment. IRA, that means infrared radiation. The wavelengths of infrared radiation lies in between 700 nanometer to 10 to the power 6 nanometer. The IRA is divided into three segments depending on the heating effect. Number one, near infrared wavelength 700 nanometer to 2500 nanometer. Middle infrared wavelength 2500 nanometer to 25000 nanometer. Far infrared wavelength 25000 nanometer to 10 to the power 6 nanometer. Most of the case, far infrared radiation is used in medical science for different treatment like cancer treatment, IR therapy, skin disease, etc. Sometimes doctors ask patient to take therapy to relieve pain. That is the infrared radiation therapy. Besides this, near infrared radiation is used for the identification of liver disease, brain disease, and bacterial infection in human body. MRI test in diagnosis of disease. MRI means magnetic resonance imaging. MRI is the most modern diagnosis technique of brain, spinal cord, cardiovascular imaging. MRI is a test that uses magnetic field, radio wave, and a computer to create the three-dimensional picture of different organs of human body. MRI based on the magnetic resonance of hydrogen atom, which is present in water of human body. When the patient inserts the MRI machine, then under the influence of magnetic field, the hydrogen atom of the human body arranges to different energy level. One is lower energy level or alpha energy level, other is higher energy level or beta energy level. In lower energy level, the nuclei of hydrogen atom resides in the parallel spin, and in higher energy level, the nuclei of hydrogen atom resides in anti-parallel spin. When the radio wave applied in the body, then the nuclei of hydrogen atom of lower energy level absorb the radio energy and transfer from lower energy level to higher energy level. Again, come back to higher energy level to lower energy level. That means transition take place, which is called nuclear magnetic resonance. Then a radio frequency signal is generated. This radio frequency signal will be different in affected area and unaffected area. This radio frequency signal is processed in computer to create the image of the different organ of patient, and it is stored for future investigation. Now, flame test. Flame test is the one of the dry test for identification of metal ion. For flame test, we need platinum wire and Bunsen burner as apparatus, concentrate HCl and sample salt as chemicals. At first, you take a clean platinum wire and it is dipped in concentrate hydrochloric acid with very small amount of sample salt. Then it is held into oxidation flame. Then you observe different characteristics color in flame for different metal. But question arised, why concentrate HCl is used in flame test? Answer will be, among the metal compound, especially chloride salt, is more volatile and it is gives different color in flame. When any metal compound is heated with concentrated hydrochloric acid in flame, then metal compound is converted to metal chloride and it is vaporized to produce metal ion. This metal ion take electron from nearby anion and produce metal atom. This metal atom absorb energy from the flame and emitted the different color in flame for different metal atom. For example, if we take the calcium carbonate for flame test, at first calcium carbonate reacts with concentrated hydrochloric acid, then produce calcium chloride, carbon dioxide and water. This calcium chloride is vaporized and produce calcium ion and chloride ion. This calcium ion accept electron from the chloride ion and produce calcium metal. This calcium metal absorb energy from flame and show the brick red color in flame. Similarly, sodium show the golden yellow color in flame. Last topics, detection of basic radicals and acid radicals in solution. For the detection of basic radical and acid radical in solution, at first you make a Stokes solution. How will you make a Stokes solution? You take a small amount of sample in a test tube, then you add distilled water, then shake well. If you obtain clear solution, that will be the Stokes solution. From this Stokes solution, you take a small amount of solution in another test tube and detect one by one cation and anion. At first, sodium ion. For the detection of sodium ion, you take 1 to 2 milliliter Stokes solution in a test tube, then you add the potassium pyroantimonate. If you obtain the white precipitation, then you will be confirmed sodium ion present in your sample. Reaction will be sodium ion plus potassium pyroantimonate K2H2SB2O7 produce sodium pyroantimonate Na2H2SB2O7 plus potassium ion white precipitation. Finish sodium ion. Now calcium ion. For the identification of calcium ion, number 2, calcium ion, you take 1 to 2 milliliter Stokes solution in a new test tube. Then you add ammonium oxalate in this test tube. If you obtain white precipitation, which is soluble in dilute hydrochloric acid, then you will be confirmed the calcium ion present in your sample. The reaction will be calcium ion plus ammonium oxalate and produce calcium oxalate. It is white precipitation and ammonium ion. This white precipitation is soluble in water, HCl. Number 3, aluminium ion. For the identification of aluminium ion, you take 1 to 2 milliliter Stokes solution in a new test tube. Then you add a small amount of ammonium hydroxide solution. Then you obtain jelly-like white precipitation. After that, you add the excess sodium hydroxide solution in this test tube. Then this white precipitation is dissolved. At last, ammonium chloride solution is added in this test tube. Then you again obtain white precipitation of aluminium hydroxide. The reaction will be aluminium ion plus ammonium hydroxide. First produce aluminium hydroxide plus ammonium ion. It is jelly-like white precipitation. When you added excess sodium hydroxide solution in this test tube, then this precipitation is dissolved and forms sodium aluminate plus water. Finally, when you added ammonium chloride solution in this test tube, ammonium chloride, then again obtained white precipitation of aluminium hydroxide. Okay, now copper ion number four copper ion. For the identification of copper ion, you take 1 to 2 milliliter stock solution in a test tube, then you add potassium ferrocyanide solution and you obtained reddish brown precipitation, then you confirm that copper ion present in your sample. The reaction will be copper ion, potassium ferrocyanide, and obtain the copper ferrocyanide. Reddish brown precipitation plus potassium ion. Number five, ferrous ion. You take 1 to 2 milliliter stock solution in a test tube and add potassium ferrocyanide solution. Then you obtain light blue precipitation. The reaction will be ferrous ion plus potassium ferrocyanide and produce K2FeCN6, name potassium ferrous ferrocyanide, light blue precipitation plus potassium ion. Okay, number six, ferric ion. Again, you take 1 to 2 milliliter stock solution in a test tube, then you add potassium ferrocyanide, again potassium ferrocyanide, then you obtain deep blue precipitation. The reaction will be ferric ion plus K4FeCN6, potassium ferrocyanide, then you obtained FeCN6. It is potassium ferric ferrocyanide plus potassium ion. It is deep blue precipitation. Number seven, zinc ion. Zinc ion, again you take 1 to 2 milliliter stock solution in a test tube, then add again potassium ferrocyanide solution, then you obtained white precipitation. the reaction will be zinc ion plus potassium ferrocyanide K4FeCN6, then produce zinc ferrocyanide. Plus potassium ion, it is white precipitation. Okay, last cation, ammonium ion. Last cation, ammonium ion. For the identification of ammonium ion, we use Nessler solution. Nessler solution. What is Nessler solution? The alkaline potassium tetraiodomercurate. I repeat it. Alkaline potassium tetraiodomercurate solution is called Nessler solution. The formula K2HZi4 plus sodium or potassium hydroxide. It is Nessler solution. If you add Nessler solution in ammonium ion solution, then you obtain brown precipitation. The reaction will be, at first, ammonium ion reacts with potassium hydroxide, then produce ammonia gas plus water and potassium ion. Then Nessler reagent K2HZi4 is dissociated, produce potassium iodide and mercuric iodide. This mercuric iodide is two molecules of mercuric iodide combined together form dimer of mercuric iodide. Finally, this dimer of mercuric iodide reacts with ammonia, produce amino mercuric iodide. This is brown precipitation. Brown precipitation. Okay, finish cation. Now, acid radical. In our syllabus, three acid radicals are present. Number one, chloride ion, sulfate ion, and carbonate ion. For the identification of chloride ion, we need silver nitrate, and for the identification of sulfate and carbonate ion, we need barium chloride or barium nitrate. At first, chloride ion. Number one, chloride ion. You take a small amount of stock solution in a test tube, then you add silver nitrate solution in this test tube. Then you obtained white precipitation of silver chloride, which is soluble in ammonium hydroxide. That means in this test tube, if you add excess amount of ammonium hydroxide, then this precipitation is dissolved. It was white precipitation. White precipitation, and after adding ammonium hydroxide, this precipitation is dissolved and produce complex compound name diamino silver chloride. It is soluble. finish chloride ion. Now, sulfate ion. For the identification of sulfate ion, you take 1 to 2 milliliter stock solution in a test tube, then add barium nitrate solution in this test tube. Number 2, sulfate ion. Add barium nitrate solution in this sulfate ion solution, then you obtained white precipitation of barium sulfate, which is insoluble in hydrochloric acid and produce nitrate ion white precipitation. Finish sulfate ion. Finally, carbonate ion. For the identification of carbonate ion, again you add barium nitrate solution in the test tube. Number 3, carbonate ion. You take the 1 to 2 milliliter stock solution in a test tube, then you add barium nitrate in this solution, then you obtained white precipitation of barium carbonate, which is soluble in HCl. That means this barium carbonate reacts with HCl, produce soluble barium chloride, carbon dioxide and water. It is white precipitation. Finish all basic radicals and acidic radicals. My dear student, now a homework. This is DA4X in a solution. Here atomic number of A equal to 1, D equal to 7, atomic number, and X equal to 17. Question: detect the basic and acidic radical in this solution. Detect basic radical and acid radical in the solution of STEM. Okay, my dear student, no more today. Allah Hafiz.